So all these three systems were having some problem. Those problems are resolved in new system called value added tax system, white paper law, okay, and they started calling sales tax at VAT. The name of sales tax was changed to VAT, value added tax. Now let me teach you how VAT operates and then only you copy. Please do not copy simultaneously, okay. You tell me data you already know now. What was the cost to manufacturer? Zero. What was the value addition? 100. So what is the subtotal here we have? 100, right? Now what is the value, and what is the multi-point tax? What is the multi-point tax? Okay, so multi-point means every person will pay tax. All right, so he paid how much?
10
rupees. So what will be the invoice value? 110. Okay, now here one more calculation we have to do. Okay, acha beta, this is your invoice, huh? Focus on your invoice. This is how your invoice looks like. All right, now here we have to do one more calculation, and that one more calculation is how much tax is payable to government. Okay, now here there are two words, output tax and input tax. Output tax means tax payable on sales, and input tax means tax payable on purchase. All right, although this guy did not purchase anything, right, whatever he had done value addition, that is because of his manufacturing activity. All right, it is the assumption. We can have 2-3 manufacturers also, but my assumption is that whatever is value addition is done by manufacturer. We will discuss manufacturer point later. We are now in trader category. All right, sir. Now let us see what is output VAT payable. So output VAT payable, output VAT, how much payable? 10 rupees. And this is the first time when government launched concept of ITC. What is ITC, beta? Input tax credit. But he doesn't have any input tax credit. He doesn't have, this is my assumption. He may have. In real life, he will get some credit. But in my example, it is not there. Okay. And that's why, what is his final tax liability? VAT liability. VAT liability means actually he was supposed to pay 10. And he doesn't have any credit, he doesn't have any coupon system, set of system, so he'll pay 10 rupees. Alright, clear up to this? Yeah, as of now government enjoyed how much rupees, beta? As of now government enjoyed 10 rupees. Multi-point system, like this it is happening now. Compare with this, this is also multi-point, this is also multi-point. But this was a bad system, this is the good system. You go and check and you again tell me what is appropriate number. What is the appropriate number that government should get out of old three number? In first system, government got 10 rupees. In second system, government got 34 rupees. And in third system, government is getting 100. So in second system, government got 34 rupees. Why 34? Because I am writing the data here. What was the selling price? 340. And 10% tax, right? And consumer got commodity at 3? So this data is there from your last point system. Same price, I'll bring here, same price, I'll bring this price of commodity for consumer, I'm 100% sure, okay, 374 I'm writing here because consumer 100% he will get goods at 374, at the same time I'm 100% sure government will get 34 and everybody will pay tax. Multi-point tax, everybody will pay tax, but consumer is happy now. And government is also happy. And why low tax evasion, sir? Because everybody is paying. That means manufacturer paid 10. Now see, you are now confused. I can see that face. But allow me to complete my chart. You will understand the system. And that's why I said VAT is the best system as compared to all old systems. Okay. So what is the cost here? What is the cost? How much he paid? How much he paid? How much he paid? 110. Because this is invoice. I told you that. Focus on invoice. He paid 110, but you know, surprisingly, his cost is not 110, his cost is 100. This is a game. Then what happened with sir 10 rupees? He paid 10 rupees. Obviously, he paid extra 10 rupees. That 10 rupees I am writing here as an input tax credit. This is current asset. He is having credit with him. Sir, what will he do with his credit? He can take set off whenever he has liability. So I am giving everybody Pizza Hut 300 rupees coupon today. What will you do? Can you redeem it to MACD? No. I gave you Pizza Hut coupon. To redeem that, you have to go to Pizza Hut. You have to buy pizza. Now, pizzas are available at 500 rupees. Will you come back home? No, you will buy it for 500. But will you pay 500? No, you will redeem the coupon. You will redeem that coupon, 300 rupees, and balance? 200. This system they had. In what? So, I paid 110. I paid to manufacture 110. But this paper is my coupon. This paper is my coupon. With this paper, paper means what is this? Invoice. I can take a set off of rupees 10. Sir, how do you know that set off of rupees 10? Beta, what is tax written here? 10. So that is my set off. This is my coupon. Then what is my cost? Because I know 10 rupees I can set off later on. So what is my cost? 100. Okay. Now what will happen in this case, sir? His value addition 90. So what will be the price? 190. 10% again he will charge. 190. Again, this is the invoice. Huh? This is how invoice looks like. Invoice made by this guy. He is ready to sell at 190, but he cannot sell at 190. He has to charge tax. Again, I am highlighting this part. Invoice, coupon. So how much he will charge from customer? 209. I said customer, not consumer. Why? Because wholesaler is not consumer. Alright. So he charged 209 and he is liable to pay 19. But will he pay 19? No. Because he is having 10 rupees coupon, right? So he will pay only 9. Now can you intelligently tell me the price or cost to the wholesaler? Focus on invoice. Obviously, sir, price for cost for this guy is 190. Then what happened with this, sir? 19 rupees that extra I paid. Ask him. Are you a consumer? No, you are a customer, a dealer. So you will get coupon. This is coupon for you. So you will get 19 rupees. No, nahi samjha. Main manta hai, nahi samjha. Aur ek bar padhayega na fir. If you say understood, then I have to stop here. They say that, sir, we did not understand. Then I'll teach on it. Okay? One more time. Please give me a question. I want to teach one more time. Sir, his value addition? 80. He is ready to sell these goods at? 270. But he cannot sell because he has to charge 27. So he will sell at? 297. This is again invoice. What is his output liability? 27. But will he pay 27? No. No, he will take a coupon 19 and he'll pay 8. Alright? Understood? 50% but understood. 50% still not understand. Again, one more time, please. Sir, again intelligent answer I'm expecting. What is the cost for this guy? 270. What is his coupon? 27. How do you know this is 27? Because sir, he paid 27. So it is 27. Alright. Very good. 70. 340. But he cannot sell at 340. 34. 374. His output liability 34, but he'll pay 7. So look at the government. Government in cash earned how much? 10 rupees from manufacturer, 9 rupees from dealer, 8 rupees from wholesaler, and 7 rupees from retailer. If you add all this, 34. Eureka! Abracadabra. Jun. Value addition. Cash cutting effect is removed. Yes. Go and check. What was the value addition done by this guy? 100 he charged, 10 rupees in this system also. So this guy is neutral. But here, old system. See, I kept intentionally old system on my board. What was the value in this 200? Are what was value of goods? 190. And what was the tax component? 10. And that's why there is a cascading effect. 1 rupee tax on tax, tax on tax. Here, what is the value? And what is the tax component? Sir, if you compare this system and this system, this is 220 rupees and this is 19 rupees. That means 1 rupee is gone. And what is that 1 rupee? Cascading effect. Tax on tax effect has been eliminated. This is the biggest disadvantage of multi-point system. And this is the biggest advantage of VAT system. That's why here I am writing merit first. What is my first merit? Elimination of cascading effect. Why it is eliminated? Because of input tax credit system. Right? They launch what? Whatever tax you paid, do not add in your cost, keep it separate and use it for paying your liability. So, although what has happened here, you know, look at the trader side, dealer side. Dealer was supposed to pay 19 rupees. 19 rupees to government, Maharashtra government. But he went to Maharashtra government and said, sir, I already paid 10 rupees to my manufacturer and you are also asking for 90 rupees. Sir, this is not fair. I already paid and I am not consumer. So, I need credit of that 10. I'll pay only 9 rupees. Are you clear from dealer's angle now? If you are a dealer. Sir, as a consumer, will this guy book credit? And where will you use that? If this guy book credit, can he use this credit? He is not liable to pay. And that's why he is not able to book credit. Is it a registered person? No. All these are registered person. Alright, that means who can book credit, beta? Tell me. Registered dealer or unregistered dealer?
Registered
dealer. That means who will pay tax to government, registered or unregistered? Who will pay? Government. Who will go to government to pay tax?
Registered
dealer. But who will take a burden? Consumer or unregistered dealer, because that guy cannot take a credit. So input tax credit, वरदान है या पाप है? वरदान है, आशीर्वाद है भगवान का, ले लो, right? And that's why we say that this is the best system. I believe that this is the best system as of now. Then we will make one more chart and I'll tell you what are the challenges that trader face in this system. Okay, one of the challenge was ghost trader. Now this guy can take credit only if this guy had paid taxes. And what used to happen, this guy is not real guy, this is a ghost dealer. That means he collected VAT from you and then he vanished. Now government is worried about tax collection and sometimes government was not giving you tax credit because that guy did not pay. So I used to fight, then go and search him. Then they are saying that it is not available. Then I am saying that it is not my fault. They are saying that, sir, that ghost was created by you. You are a Ganesh trader and you created fake Ramesh trader. Printing bill is difficult in India. No, we can print two original property papers. Two original, huh? I am not saying duplicate. Two original property paper. Printing two bills is not a difficult task. That means if you want to reduce your tax liability, what you have to do? Go and find a bill. Go and search a bill. That's why people were doing tax evasion. Is it a tax planning? No, that is a tax evasion. Tax ki chori. Possible thi ya nahi? Thi. Abhi nahi hai. How? Because the moment he pays the tax, then only it will be reflected in his account, because both are happening now online under GST portal. This guy cannot see this 19 rupees unless and unless this guy pays that. Okay? And this guy cannot deny of paying taxes, because the moment he upload his return, government will send notice to this guy, sir, somebody is taking input tax credit, why don't you pay now? And now government can go and raid this guy and take taxes. sir, but this guy is not in existence. Beta, this guy was having bank account. They'll seize bank account. Sir, how will they come about his bank account? Bank account is linked with PAN. PAN is linked with Aadhaar. Aadhaar is linked with your mobile. They can send you message. Hi. WhatsApp. Yeah? Sir, I don't have any demerit here, but you can say, you know, fake invoices. Fake invoicing was possible. Demerits, for I'm not going to write demerits because I love this system. But there are demerits. I told you what is the demerit. Fake. So system was right. People were wrong, yaar. System is perfect. But people who are implementing the system, they were doing wrong thing. I'm not going to write my, you know, demerit. One demerit I believe. Increase in working capital requirement. Increase in? Why? Because, you know, if you check the second system, this guy was purchasing these commodities at 100 rupees. Now, this guy requires to pay 110. Sir, but he is getting credit. Are to help with that credit? I can use that credit only if I could sell these goods further. That means if I don't sell these goods for 6 months, my 10 rupees is blocked for 6 months. And that's why there is an increase in working capital requirement. Okay. So if you want, I can write, but seriously, I'm not writing voluntarily. Okay. I'm writing because you are looking at me this angry face, or you know, you are not happy with me. So demerit. So what happens here? What kind of demerits we can write here? Increase in tax compliances. Now look at the first demerit. What dealers are saying, sir, because of that it is increase in tax compliance. Tax compliance means they have to visit chartered accountant now. They don't understand how this system works. So they go to chartered accountant, and chartered accountant, every time customer sees chartered accountant charge, mu dikhai ki rasam. Every time you come and see me, I'll charge you. Because I'm a chartered accountant. Why do you go to doctor? To buy medicine? No, you buy medicine from chemist. You go to doctor just to know which medicine you need. So why people come to chartered accountant? Just for opinion. What to do, how to do, everything they'll do. Customer will do. But the law, the opinion will be given by chartered accountant. And do you think that we sell that for free of cost? So what doctor is doing? Just writing two words on your prescription that he is writing, and for that he is charging 200 rupees. But he is a doctor, he knows which medicine you need now. So as a chartered accountant, we know what kind of solutions you need as of now. We are the solution providers. Okay? Yeah? Second. High tax evasion or low tax evasion? Achha, here I have to write low tax evasion. Why low tax evasion? Because it is a multi-point tax. Everybody is paying tax. Alright? These are the two main advantages. Second advantage, ghost dealer. Or I can write fake invoices. Then, kacha bill, pakka bill. Have you heard this word? With bill, without bill, go to alpha. Andheri ro. Camera with bill 30,000. Without bill 25,000. Mumbai, Andheri, everybody knows. Even income tax people go there to buy. And with bill, without bill. We want without bill because we have cash. Right? With bill and without bill concept. So, kacha bill, pakka bill, these concepts were there. Increase in tax compliance, fake invoice, and what was the one more? Increase in working capital. Increase in working capital. Alright. Achha, sir. This was a sales tax, no? First point tax, sales tax. Last point tax, sales tax. This was also multi-point tax was sales tax. Why the hell we are calling it as a value-added tax? Because everybody is paying tax on value addition. Nobody is paying tax on sales. Earlier they were paying tax on sales value. Now everybody is paying tax on value addition. What was the value addition done by manufacturer? manufacturer, 100 rupees, okay. What is the tax rate, value added tax rate? 10%. Tax is 10 rupees. What is the value addition done by distributor? Tax rate? 9. What is the value addition done by wholesaler? Tax rate? 8. 77. You do your value addition, pay tax on your value addition. How? Input, output. Formula is different. We cannot compute tax like this. But you should know you are paying tax only on your own value addition. Okay. Clear? Yeah? Please pause it.